have a look at a very good example. So in this case, we have been given a series and we need to find the sum of this series up to n terms. So what we have here is, let's say first we try to find what it is. What is the common difference? 11 minus 5, 6. What is the common difference here? 19 minus 11, 8. 29 minus 19, 10. And here we have 41 minus 29, 12. So the common difference is not fixed. Therefore, this is not an AP. Okay, let's check if it is an GP. If it is a GP, 11 by 5 is not equal to 19 by 11. So this is also not a geometric progression. So what do we do now? It is neither a GP nor an AP. We can't apply the formula that we learned. But one thing which we could observe here is the common difference that is there between the successive terms. This thing is forming an AP. So the common difference here is 11 minus 5, 6, 19 minus 11 is 8, 29 minus 19 is 10. So the common difference here is making an AP. So if somehow we could use this fact, then we can solve this question. So let's see what we can do. We can have here is SN as 5 plus 11 plus 19 plus 29 41 and let's say so on up to the nth term, let us denote by an. Now since the common difference is making an arithmetic progression, so what we could do is we could just shift the expression by one term. So what I mean is write 5 underneath this one, 5 plus 11 plus 19 plus 29 and so on. And since we have shifted it by one term, we'll have our n minus 1th term here and our nth term here. And now simply this is our equation 1, this is our equation 2. Now what we could do is simply subtract both of them. So if you subtract, then the sign changes here, it changes to minus, 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 so on. Minus. Now what happens is this thing gets cancelled out. This is 0. 5 comes out here as 5. 11 minus 5 we will have 6, right? 19 minus 11 we will have 8. 29 minus 19 we will have 10. 41 minus 19 we will have 12. And so on. If you continue, then this, how many terms will we have here? So this is n terms, we are not considering one term, so there will be n minus 1 terms here in this thing here. So this total is n, so one term we just write as here, so this will be n minus 1 term. So this one will go on up to n minus 1 term here. And in the end we will have this minus an coming here. I hope you got what we did here. We just simply wrote the series, what we had here, we shifted it by one term, 5 plus 11, 19, 29 and so on. And then we simply subtracted it, and when you do it, you get 0, you get the first term 5, and now this thing will form an AP, the difference 11 minus 5, 6, 19 minus 11, 8, 29 minus 19, 10 and so on. And we need to find out how many number of terms are there in this. So this thing was n terms, we didn't consider one term, so this will be n minus 1. Therefore, in this arithmetic progression, there will be n minus 1 terms. And we also have this term in the end, minus an. Therefore, now, what do we have? Let's bring an on the other side. An is equal to 5 plus, now this is simply an arithmetic progression with a common difference of 2 and first term as 6. So we can simply use our formula, which we know is n by 2 times 2a plus n minus 1 times d. So n by 2, n here is n minus 1. Therefore we have n by 2 times 2a. 2a is 12. 2a plus n minus 1. So n minus 1 minus 1. N minus 2 times d. D is 2. I hope you got what we did here. The first term is 6, so this is 2a 12 plus n minus 1. Here n is n minus 1 already, so it will be n minus 1 minus 1. Therefore we have n minus 2 times d. which is 2. Just to again write here, we just use the formula here, n by 2 times 2a plus n minus 1 times d. This is the formula that we used here. Now if you solve it, you'll get something like 5 plus n minus 1 times n plus 4. If you just take 2 as common and 2 comes out, then this will be 6 plus n minus 2, or this will be n plus 4. Therefore, what we have here is a n is equal to n square plus 3n plus 1. Therefore, you will have n square, 4n minus n, 3n, and you will have minus 4 plus 5. Therefore, you will have a n as n square plus 3n plus 1. Now, but what was our initial aim? Our aim was to find the sum of this expression until n terms. But what we did instead was to find the nth term, the expression for general term of this series here. So instead, so just to check if indeed this is the general term, if you substitute n, what do you get? 1 square, 1 plus 3 plus 1, that is 5. If you substitute 2, you will get 2 square 4 plus 6 plus 1, 11. If you substitute 3, 3 square is 9 plus 9, 18 plus 1, 19. So indeed, this is the general term for this series here. Now, we just need to find the sum of this series. Now, in order to find the sum of the series, it's very easy. What is a sum up to n terms? It will just be simply the sum of general term k from 1 to n, right? So what do we have here? We have ak as this thing here. Therefore, we can write this as summation of k square plus 3k plus 1 k from 1 to n. Or we can take the summation inside. Therefore, we'll have summation of k square k from 1 to n plus 3 times, again, summation of k, k from 1 to n, plus summation of 1, k from 1 to n. Or we know this expression here. It will be n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 divided by 6, right? This will be n times n plus 1 divided by 2, and this we are just adding 1 n number of times. So this will be n. Now if you want to just simplify it further, you can simplify the expression, and in the end you can find that the expression will be something like this. Hence, this is your answer. This is the sum of the series given above. This was a very beautiful question. I think we need to review it once. So this was the original series for which we wanted to find the sum. 5 plus 11 plus 19 and so on. But we found that this is neither forming an AP nor a GP. But one thing which we could observe is its common difference is in AP. So 11 minus 5 is 6, 19 minus 11 is 8, 29 minus 19 is 10, and 41 minus 29 is 12. So this thing here is forming an AP. So what we made use here is we just shifted the term by one term. We just shifted the series by one term. So we got 5, 11, 19, so on up to an, and then if we shift it, and now you just subtract it, you get this as 0, you get 5 here. And now the fact that this thing was forming an AP, we can use it here. We get n minus 1 terms here in the form of an arithmetic progression. And we get one extra minus an since we shifted by one term. Now we can simply use the formula for an arithmetic progression here. So what is the formula for arithmetic progression? Sum of arithmetic progression, n by 2 times 2a plus n minus 1 times d. So n here is n minus 1 since we have n minus 1 terms. So n minus 1 divided by 2 times 2a, a is 6, therefore 12, and then we get n minus 2 times 2. And from this you could find a general expression for its general term, an. is equal to n square plus 3n plus 1, and you can check by substituting 1, 2, 3 in place of n if you find these terms here. So this is representing a general form of this series. Now, in order to find sum, what we need to do, we just need to sum this general term, right? So this sum is k square plus 3k plus 1. Now you can just take this summation inside, and then we have derived the formula for this expression here, this expression here, and this is just adding 1n number of times. And if you simplify, then you get this solution in the end. So this is a very beautiful example where we made use of many different facts that we know. And to start with, at the very beginning, we used this observation and then started in this line of thinking. Now this may seem very difficult in the very first time when you solve it, like how do I think about these innovative things. So these things will just come, you just practice it, and then once, if you have done this kind of thing, now the next time ever in your life, if you see this kind of thing, then you can simply try this and you will be able to solve it.